Welcome. We're going to be walking you through NVIDIA's GeForce Experience software today. And I thought, what better way of showing everyone how it works than by using NVIDIA GeForce Experience and ShadowPlay to record it. So here we are. We're running this is my everyday machine. This is a Core i7 4930K, 16 gig RAM, GTX 980s and SLI on an ASUS ROG Swift 27-inch 1440p monitor, 144Hz G-Sync. It's a really, really nice system. I use it to play Battlefield 4 every couple of days for a couple of hours to test out headsets and different video card setups and to test out the G-Sync monitors that I've been reviewing lately. But GeForce Experience, the more I've been using it for shadow play and modifying my games and enabling DSR, which is a dynamic super resolution that NVIDIA unveiled last month with the Maxwell architecture for the GTX 980 and 970. So now we're going to run you through GeForce Experience. So GeForce Experience will install with your drivers. You can choose to have a shortcut on the desktop or have it running in the bottom right here. And once it loads up, you've got a bunch of things that you can actually do with the software, which is incredibly useful. So as I said, I'm actually recording this right now with ShadowPlay. So you can see up here in the top right, that little green dot means that we're recording and it's all going good. And the microphone is there because obviously it's picking up the USB microphone that I have plugged in to record my voice. Now, you can choose to do different things with ShadowPlay in terms of recording your video quality. You can do different resolutions, you can do different bit rates. We're going to go into that in a minute, but we'll just run through what GeForce Experience actually does in each of its sections. So, starting with games. GeForce Experience will detect all of your games that are installed, or you can manually add them. You can click the refresh game list down here. You can see down here that you can optimize all your games automatically for your NVIDIA hardware, and then you can actually go into preferences. So we can go into preferences and we can see that on my system I've got 11 games installed, and it's finding the specific folders of where I've actually got the games installed. It will tell you when it's last been checked, and you can force it to actually manually check now, and then you can actually have it scan every day for games, as you can see here, and you can actually enable optimal game settings and let NVIDIA pretty much do it for you. And then you can actually have you can be messaged or notified when optimal settings are actually updated on your game. It's really, really cool. You can actually change a lot of stuff in here. So you can see that I'm running all current because I do benchmarks on this machine. So this is the way I have it set up for our benchmarks. But you can just click this little optimize button here and it will just bam, it'll optimize it. So I'm just going to do this now for Batman Arkham Origins. So you can hear that I've optimized it and it's enabled all those settings that NVIDIA recommended from the cloud. NVIDIA actually hire a considerable amount of people that go through every single game with hundreds of or thousands of combinations of video cards to find out the best combination of how to run your hardware running the games that we're all playing today. So this is Batman Arkham Origins with the NVIDIA optimized settings. You can just click revert and it'll go back to how it used to be, and then you can start editing certain parts of here. So you can choose a resolution, you can optimize it for quality or performance, so you can drag it right down and you'll see all the settings on the custom bit here. They'll all change based on whether you want to have super performance where it turns off, you know, ambient occlusion, depth of field, it turns off a bunch of additional visual features, or you can go right up to optimal or up to the highest quality, which you can see there just changes the anti-aliasing from GeForce TXAA low, which is NVIDIA's optimal and recommended setting, to high. So you can do, there's just so many changes there. That's just on the outside. You can go inside and change a few of the options in the game, but most of these are included in the game. It's just easier to do it from here. So you can see here, it's telling me to run optimal four times AA. So for example, for Battlefield 4, I'm not going to run four times AA. I'm going to run, I want the highest frames a second because I've got a 144Hz screen. So I'm not going to run four times AA, which is going to really reduce, my performance. But you can see here, we've got 2560 by 1440. So if we click on here, you can actually again, you can go between performance and quality, which is a really, really nice touch. It's just, again, it's really, really easy to use. you can, and obviously it tells you over here as well that the game's unoptimized. And down here you've actually got a preview, and it shows you little bits of what it actually does. So you can see here, like most people, or not most people, some people don't know what ambient occlusion is. So you can see here it explains ambient occlusion: adds soft shadows to crevices and objects that are in close proximity to one another, dramatically improving image quality. You can see here it tells you what anti-aliasing deferred does. Let's see if there's any hot points. No. But as you change these settings, it actually results in the image below being edited, kind of like in real time. So you can see here, if I drop it down to there, this will all change here. If I go back to revert, no, it doesn't. Oh, no, okay, sorry. I thought it did, but it does not do that. But here, obviously, it just shows you, you've got a couple of screenshots here, and it will show you all the different things that the graphical settings will do. So again, you're talking about here dynamic super sampling anti-aliasing, that's a tongue twister there, and what it can do for you. There's a couple of others here, again just little lighting quality, terrain. It's really a really nice touch that you can actually go through and just, and again, for people that don't know what those terms mean, you can be walked through it. So that's the game section. Next, we've got drivers. This is another really nice touch where you can actually have drivers downloaded for you automatically, and then it will install them and reboot and do it all for you with just a couple of clicks without you having to go to NVIDIA's website, download the drivers manually, install the drivers manually, reboot. This is actually like a really, really nice little touch here. It shows you that I've got the latest installed driver for the Maxwell cars, the GeForce 344.16 drivers. They were released a couple of weeks ago, and you can check updates up here. And you can also look for beta drivers, which is nice. Some people like myself will most of the time want to use beta drivers. I'm not going to necessarily want to use the official drivers. The next one is My Rig. It shows you what system you've got. So obviously I've got GTX 980s and SLI. I've got a Core i7 4930K at stock, 16 gigabytes of RAM, the Asus ROG Swift G-Sync 144Hz 1440p display, which is absolutely amazing. If you're a gamer, you need to go buy one today. Turn off this video and go buy one. And then you've got a little rundown within your rig. You can actually customize your rig, which is pretty much its own app within the app, which is another really, really, really cool thing that I absolutely thoroughly love with GeForce Experience. So you can see here that there's multiple parts here. We're going to go from obviously the overview, showing that there's game optimization, there's game stream, shadow play, and the LED visualizer. It's going to game optimization, which is what we walked you through before, which is optimizing your game settings for your PC for most of the games that are out there on the market right now. And then you've got game stream, which will actually stream your games from your NVIDIA GeForce Power PC, which requires a specific GPU, 600 series and higher, or the notebook series GTX 660M series and higher, and a few other requirements, 4 gig of RAM, Windows 7, Windows 8, and a certain driver that you need, as well as a decent router to be able to do all of that, because it's all done over the Wi-Fi network. This will stream your game, so you might have a game that's not on a console or not on a TV, so a game, or even just for example, a game like Tomb Raider, where it's a third-person adventure game. It plays incredibly well with a controller, not so great with a mouse and keyboard, and it looks awesome on the TV. You're not getting that input lag that you get with first-person shooters because of the third-person nature of the game. So that will, if you've got a Shield or a Shield tablet, that will do everything for you within here. ShadowPlay is what I'm recording this on right now, an amazing piece of software. We're going to go into that in a minute. And LED visualizer. So on specific GPUs, so we've got the GTX 980 reference cards, you can actually go in and configure the LEDs on them, which I do. I have a flow-in effect, so the light will flow in and it will flow out. But there's tons of options here. There's tons: breathing, flashing, dual flashing, random, electric, flow-in, flow-out, reverse breathing, ripple, audio flashing. You can have the variation change to star-based. You can have the brightness going up and down. You can completely turn off the effects. You can turn it on only when SLI is enabled. And then when you've got the style set, so say, for example, I want to choose breathing, it actually adjusts the breathing speed. So I can go up to max, down to low. If I'm going to go back to my flow-in setting, I'm going to go halfway. You can go up to 3/4, apply, and it will do it straight away. You can also click GPU properties. It'll tell you the temperature of your GPUs, the fan speed, and the utilization. And it does it to each individual GPU, depending on how many you've got. So obviously we've got two, and my second one obviously is doing something, and I would say that that's probably the ShadowPlay that I'm recording this on. You can do with the LED settings, you can actually do all LEDs, or you can choose per card. So you can do LED for the GeForce, for the first GeForce card, second GeForce, and so forth. The second to last is the Shield, which ran through before, so you can actually stream your games using Game Stream from your desktop PC to your Shield or your Shield tablet. In preferences, that's what we were going into before, and now we're going to go into ShadowPlay, which was what we're all here for today. ShadowPlay is amazing. I use it for Battlefield 4 videos. Me and my brother and a couple of friends, we play Battlefield 4 against each other, or as a team, I should say, and we will record our footage. All of us are running GeForce powered systems. My brother's running a GTX 770. My nephew's running GTX 770. And I've got a friend, Tristan, he runs a GeForce GTX 780 Ti. So we've all got decent GeForce GPUs that can all record, you know, 1080p 60fps, which is great. It is really, really great. You can have your camera positioned there. So if you're doing Twitch streaming or you're doing it professionally, like, so I could have my webcam pick me up, which we're going to be doing in the next couple of weeks. I'm going to be doing videos for you guys with the camera and then using ShadowPlay to record it. You can have it in different positions. So you can choose where you want everything to be. So we're going to run through ShadowPlay now. So you can actually click into ShadowPlay up here in the top right, and then you're going to have a bunch of options. So right now, I'm obviously recording the video, so I can't show you how to edit this kind of stuff, but you can click mode, and you can actually turn it between shadow and manual. Shadow recording, what happens is that you'll be playing a game. So for example, you might be flying around in Battlefield 4, and you do a really, really nice kill. You might get like a couple of headshots in a row. You might do a really nice rocket into the back of a tank, or you might take a heli out of the air with a rocket, which is always amazing to see. And then what you can do is you just press Alt F10, and it'll actually record the last X amount of time. So X being minutes. So you see here, that's your shadow time. Shadow time can be up to 20 minutes, which uses about 7.5 gig of hard drive space. And you can actually adjust that. So you can go, you know, 15 minutes or 10 minutes or 5 minutes or even one or two. You can adjust the recording resolution, which is something that I didn't think you'd be able to play with as much, but you can actually adjust the resolution of the recording. So right now I'm recording at 1440p, so 2560 by 1440 at 60 frames a second, 50 megabit bitrate, and I'm using the H.264 codec. So you can, again, you can adjust the quality in here. We're going to have a written portion that will have screenshots of this. But if you've got an NVIDIA GPU, you can come in here and play around with it by yourself. And then audio. So you can actually choose to record your audio from in the game. Or you can do in-game and microphone. So right now I'm doing in-game and microphone. So if anything pops up right now, if I open up a YouTube video, for example, you would hear the audio on this video. So it's cool for doing presentations, like kind of like what I'm doing now, where I can show you something and I can capture in-game audio on microphone. So if I was to go into a game right now, you would hear the audio. You've got a couple of options for keyboard shortcuts as well. So again, before I go into that, sorry, you've got microphone. So you can do always on or push to talk. Always on is a lot easier because you can just talk without having to worry. Depending on whether you're using third-party software like TeamSpeak or Ventrilo or the in-game communications, depending on the game you're playing. Keyboard shortcuts, again, they're pretty easy to remember, but you can always edit these. So you've got a bunch of options that you can do. So again, Alt F10 is the main one that you're going to be doing because you can save your shadow recording by pressing Alt F10. I'm doing a manual recording right now. So Alt F9 started it, and I'll be finishing up in a minute or two, and I'll press Alt F9 to end it. You can broadcast directly out. You can pause the broadcast. You can turn your camera on and off during the broadcast, and you also get an FPS toggle, which is a nice touch. So ShadowPlay mixed with GeForce Experience, mixed with the FPS counter, mixed with recording at whatever quality, really thrashes what Fraps used to do years ago, all without using much of your GPU resources, if any at all. And I think that's about it for ShadowPlay, actually. You've got the last bit, you've got recording options. So you can actually change a temporary files location, and you can actually have a save location for your ShadowPlay videos. So I have a massive SanDisk 480 gig SSD. I just have it saving all in there. But again, 20 minutes is about 7.5 gig, which isn't too bad at all, considering that I'm recording at 1440p at 60 frames a second. So you could drop it down to 1080p at 30 frames a second and save a lot of space. So that's about it for NVIDIA ShadowPlay. It's an incredible piece of software. I find myself using it daily now, and I can't say that about much software. Software that I use daily for me these days would most likely be probably Google Chrome, as you can see down here. Maybe Spotify I use every day, and most of the Google apps, like I might use Hangouts, you can see down here, this is a new Hangouts. But GeForce Experience has become a daily use for me. If you don't use it and you've got a GeForce card, you really need to look at it. And if you're buying a new GPU and this is something that you could get into, I think that NVIDIA have a very, very solid piece of software here. And even though ShadowPlay is in beta, as you can see here, I have only had a couple of problems with it. Maybe sometimes it doesn't auto-initialize up here and I go to press F10 and I've done something unbelievable in Battlefield 4 and it doesn't record it. And then I'll reboot and it's fine. So I don't know what that is. I've tried reinstalling, I've tried different systems, and it seems to only happen once or twice. But other than that, it's rock solid. I haven't tried any of the shield features yet, which is again something we're going to get into in the next couple of days, next week or two. And I'll do some cool videos with that as well. But for now, that is GeForce Experience. If you have an NVIDIA GPU, I very highly recommend that you get this and play around with it, just to record cool things while you're doing it in the doing your normal gaming sessions, or even desktop footage like I'm doing now. I'm able to show you guys my desktop, and everything is nice and smooth. On my side, obviously, it's smooth. And in the video, at 60 frames a second, you're getting a smooth experience. That's NVIDIA's GeForce Experience. Thanks for watching.